This is the main event of the evening. This is a professional MMA contest scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Would you welcome to the cage first, from Hard Knocks in Leicester, James Hurrell. And now, would you welcome to the cage his opponent from AVT right here in Doncaster, scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Introducing to you firstly, in the blue corner, wearing black shorts trimmed with grey and red, he weighed in at 92 kilograms, from Hard Knocks in Leicester, James Hurrell. And his opponent across the cage in the red corner, wearing grey shorts trimmed with white, he too weighed in at 92 kilos, from AVT, right here in Doncaster, James Parker! Your referee when the action gets underway is Craig Lawrence. This is 3 5-minute rounds of professional MMA.
So this is the big fight of the night, and at 6'3", Parker is the shorter man by some way. The great thing about this fight, Jay, is you've got a man 4-0 fighting in his hometown. Great record, huge support against a man that's come down from heavyweights and I've never felt faster or stronger, and I fought better opponents. He holds no fear for me.
Yeah, it's a very interesting matchup here for James Parker. Sort of proves or could legitimise his record if he can beat a guy as tough as James Hurrell. Immediately shot him for that takedown, you know, given the size and the stature of Hurrell, you don't really want to be at the end of his reach, so it makes sense to put him on his back where he's not so tall.
That's exactly what James Parker said to me in the pre-fight interview. I said, I'd interviewed James Hurrell, I said he's 6'7". He said he's the same height when he's on his back.
Yeah, and Parker passing him out, but Hurrell gets a reversal there, just old school hip skirt, bridge up and just roll it over. I mean, you get a feeling Parker will be a little bit disappointed to let that position go to waste.
Well, this was the big thing that James Hurrell said to me. He said, it's a great record, but he's not for anyone of my quality. So he's a very confident man.
Yep, and already you've seen the back and forth that happens when you come against a tougher fighter like Hurrell, who's looking for that Kimura. But Parker does a good job of escaping out of there.
Knee from Hurrell, using his height to advantage there. Parker looking to take his man back down.
And Parker's always been a big, powerful guy for the weight. He's definitely thicker than Hurrell. But, yeah, let's see how Hurrell can defend his takedown, because so far he hasn't been able to stuff the takedown.
Looking to bull forward there, but again, the good sprawl from Hurrell, keeping himself upright.
That underhook position there really stopping Parker from fully sucking the hips in. And the long limbs allow him to lock it up nice and tight. But Parker gets it and he works with that single leg. That's a good and awful technique there from Hurrell. Somebody with shorter arms wouldn't be able to utilise that as well. And he's used it to help him clamber back to his feet, or almost at least.
Yes, Parker trying to pull his way in again. He's been quite relentless in trying to achieve this, Jay.
Yeah, he's been non-stop and he's got the reward now. He's got Hurrell on his back where he wants him. Hurrell gets to his knees. Parker, given the chance, has some vicious ground and pound.
Yes, Hurrell's got to be careful here.
Parker's got one hook in. We're on that left-hand side. Submitted, I think, two of his opponents so far. And stopped the other two with strikes from ground and pound. So this is a dangerous position for Hurrell to be in. Parker fighting for that choke. He looks to have that right arm underneath the neck.
Here we go.
And that's Lapham's time. Hurrell is in major trouble. He's managed to escape out of that choke. That looked up really tight and under the chin.
And now he lays down the ground and pound. A big moment there for both men. We thought it was all over for Hurrell.
Parker's looking for a leg lock there of some sort. Maybe a heel hook.
Hammer fist from Hurrell. He's got to watch the cage there. He's holding on to the cage.
Yeah, not allowed to grip the cage there. He looks for the toe hold. Oh, the straight foot lock. Hurrell's really grimacing. He's
in pain there, Jay. He really is in pain. And again, he's holding the fence. I mean, looking to get the angles for the hammer fist. He can only do that with holding the fence, but he escaped somehow.
Yeah, that's the difference, is it? The guys Parker has come up against so far, you know, they would have been finished by now, but Hurrell, given how tough he is and the experience he's got, he's still hanging on in there.
Finds himself on his back once more, though, in this seesaw opening round. And, Jay, a fascinating opening 2-3 minutes of this round. And twice now we thought that maybe that's it from Parker, but Hurrell's escaped and launched an offence of his own.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this is exactly the step up that Parker needed and would have wanted. You know, it's all right getting through guys and steamrolling them in the first round. You know, this is what he wants, a back and forth fight against the guy who comes in highly regarded. And so far, he's showing us just what he's made of.
Yes, you can hear the crowd roaring Parker on. Looking to lay the elbows down, but good defense again from Hurrell.
Yeah, just telegraphed that ground and pound a little bit too much, and it allowed Hurrell to just use them long limbs. He gets another reversal.
I think that's three so far in this round, Jay.
So back and forth. Exactly what the fans want in the main event as well.
Last 10 seconds as Hurrell tries the ground and pound. Equally as ineffective as Parker's attempts on him. But as you said, back and forward. So overall, we had Parker the aggressor, the man really trying to force the pace. But Hurrell kept calm and a number of reversals.
Yeah, I mean, it's a close round. Both guys definitely had success. I mean, from the commentary booth, we thought Parker had it in the bag with that rear naked choke. It just shows the durability and the grit that Hurrell's got. I mean, we're not sat here judging.
And then again, Parker got the foot as well, didn't he? And we saw the pain on Hurrell, but he worked through that as well.
Yeah, maybe giving the edge to Parker, given the dominant positions there, and, you know, he got the takedowns. Hurrell only managed to reverse from a negative position, so, you know, that's got to go in Parker's favour. But Hurrell definitely by no means out of his fight, and he's bringing a lot of skills to the table.
And he would have grown in confidence in the fact that when the round ended, he was the man in mount throwing the leather.
Yeah, that's always a good sign to take him into the second round. I'm sure he'll be enthused by that.
And a little wink at Parker there from him. So away we go again. If the second is anywhere near as good as the first. And again, Hurrell came out to throw leather. Parker to take him down.
And he looks for that sit through. A nice fast brawl there from old, such a tall guy. He got his hips down in double quick time.
He did say he's felt so much faster since he's cut the weight from heavyweight to light heavyweight.
Yeah, now he's on top in side control, looking to land some short elbows.
Yeah, the left elbow landed there the once.
Parker's got that underhook, looking for the escape. He's let Hurrell mount him really easily there. Couple of heavy shots.
And he's given him his back as well now. Will Hurrell capitalise on this?
Yeah, this is a good spot for Hurrell now. Very dominant position, and he's letting some big shots come in.
Parker's got to do something quickly here. We've said before, it's got to be intelligent defence.
Yeah, Parker is sticking in there, but Hurrell maintains that dominant position, using his long limbs just to keep a hold of him and keep him flat. Parker doing everything he can to try and wriggle out of there.
Hurrell continues to jackhammer the right hand. I don't think it's particularly powerful at the moment, but it is a dominant position for him. Tries with the downward elbows now.
Parker looks tired.
He's done it, he's done it. He's called it off because of the downward elbows. And the big test, you can see what it means to Hurrell. You can see what it means to Hurrell.
Yeah, that's a big win. He held that dominant position for a good spell of time, and he was letting off a lot of unanswered shots there. You know, Parker obviously devastated. It's the first loss he's sustained in his professional career. But he lost as an amateur and he came back. That's a big win for Hurrell. And, Parker showed signs of his own positives in the first round and just couldn't get going in the second round. Maybe a little bit frustrated and a little bit tired from his efforts in round one.
But as you said, a big win for James Hurrell. You saw what it meant to him because he made his mark. I think he was at number 20 in the heavyweights. He said, I want to make my name in the light heavies. And I think he set out a marker there.
Yeah, definitely. James Parker's the guy who was in the top 20 and a burgeoning guy. But Hurrell's taken a big scalp in his first fight at light heavyweight.
Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, could you please put your hands together for both fighters? The contest came to an end after 1 minute and 36 seconds of round number two. Your winner by TKO from Hard Knocks in Leicester, James Hurrell!
And with the winner of our big fight of the night, James Hurrell. James, I could see what that meant to you when the referee called that off.
Yeah, I was exhausted going into like that fight. I caught too much water, so I was a kilo under what I needed to be. I'm glad it's over. It's like everything I put into that. Can't feel my arms now.
Well, you said to me in the pre-fight interview, he's never fought anyone of my caliber. And that proved to be true because you had to weather a really tough first round.
Yeah, I know it'd take me down. He was like strong on the ground. he was quicker than I thought. I wanted to catch him early with like a knee as he was coming out, in. But I enjoyed that.
Well, what we thought was key was at the end of the first round, which was tough for you, but it did end with you in the mount throwing the leather. Yeah. Is that what gave you the incentive to come out so strong in the second?
No, I'm going to come out and give it my all in every fight, So that's what I did, just gave it my all. And I think I wanted it more.
Well, James, you said you wanted to make waves in the light heavyweight. You've certainly set down a marker now. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you, James.